Yeah, welcome to the in-depth tutorial about centering layouts with pins and boxes in After Effects. If you don't know yet what pins and boxes is doing, so pins and boxes allows you to create dynamic layouts. You can see when I move this icon here, for example, or let's say I want to replace this text here, make this a bit longer, and maybe also make here a line break. You can see that everything adjusts automatically. So the bounding box here updates, this text moves with it, and so on. All of these kinds of layouts can be created with pins and boxes, and they are expressions based. So all of this updates instantly, and also, for example, inside a Premiere Pro motion graphics template or whatever. And now the question I want to answer today is, okay, this looks nice, but as you can see, in my scene, this does not stay centered. Yeah, so if I have it like this, for example, it's growing here to the right, and it would be nice to have this entire layout, this entire design automatically move a bit left such that it stays perfectly centered. And this seems to be very tricky with pins and boxes, but once you know how to do it, it's actually super easy. So I assume here that you already have a basic idea how to work with pins and boxes. Yeah, so if you don't have any idea, please watch the other tutorials we have on our product page for pins and boxes for After Effects. Very quickly, the general idea is you have some pins, and you can show them here, and those pins are attached to the parts of your layout, and you can parent other things to those pins, and you can create boxes around those pins. This is in a nutshell how pins and boxes works. And now, if you want this design to center properly, the first thing is that we need a pin right in our center. If we take a look at the pins here, we don't have a pin at the center of this entire design at the moment. If you would like to say, I want to center around this part here, so like the bottom line of the box should always be perfectly in the center of my composition, you could use this pin here. But let's say we want the center to be here in the middle of this white box. So we can just select the box layer and say, please create a pin. I shift click, because when I shift click, I get this nice dialog here where I can choose the locations at which I want to have pins. I just want to have one right in the middle. And now I've got my new pin here right in the middle. Maybe let's move it at the top of my composition such that we find it easier, because we will need it a lot now. Now, if you say this is not exactly the center that I want to have, I want to do not just center this white box in my layout, but I want to center this entire thing, including the Baimamo world text here. So in other words, my center should not be this point here, but it should be a little bit lower, because I want to include this here in my calculation too. Then you could create first a box around all your content, and then make this box invisible because you don't want to see it, and then create a pin at this location. But this really depends on your layout. Key point here is create a pin at the position where you want the center of your layout to be. Now the next step is we drag this composition that we have in a new composition here to get a pre-comp essentially. So we have now here a new composition, and let's call this main centered. And inside of this, we have now our original composition as a layer. And the key idea is now this layer is inserted such that here it's right in the middle, right? The position of this is right in the middle. And if we now control the anchor point of this layer to be our pin, then our pin will always be right in the middle. So what we do is we take the two compositions and place them side by side. So now I have here my original design and our new composition here. And now here is the pin that we want to center around, and I reveal its position. It's here. And now we link the anchor point of this layer in our new main composition to this position here. So I'd really drag over to this location. And now this anchor point has always exactly the same value as this pin position. And this means inside of our main composition, the design will be moved to always be at that point. So let's see how this is looking like. Go in our pre-comp. Let's say I move this here over. And now in our pre-comp, it's looking like this. But if we go back to our main comp, you can see that inside the main comp, this box here is perfectly centered. Yeah, you see this black bar, and this is because we have some clipping going on now. This will get even worse when we move here this outside, yeah, outside of our pre-comp. Then even the white part of our design here is clipped. You can solve this by enabling here the collapse transformation. You can see now this part comes back, okay? So obviously this is just working, the green part here is just filling in, because in my precomp, if I take a look at the background layer here at the very bottom, you can see this background layer is way bigger. Yeah, of course it's not like collapse transformation is not adding content here at the side. Just make sure your background is wide enough. It's just enabling collapse transformations just makes sure that the content is not clipped at the boundaries of your composition, but extends as big as it is. And that's essentially already it. So we have now a main comp in which this design is always centered around this point that our pin indicates, and whereas in the precomp you can move it however you want, inside of the main composition it will stay centered, because it's like taking the precomp and shifting it such that this pin that you've chosen, that you've pick-whipped the anchor point to, it will always stay in the center. So a very cool aspect about this approach is that it's very flexible and works also for the most complex designs. So you can see here I've got a very complex setup where I have here, let's make this longer, and now it grows upwards here and stuff like this. So it's a very complex setup, but still, if you say I want this entire thing here to center in my composition, then let's first reveal all the pins that are involved here. There are quite a lot of them, and I just say okay, for all those pins I have none really that is at the very center of this entire thing. So let's create one by first creating a box. Now we've got a box around all those pins that we selected, and now for this box we create a pin that should be right at the center. So now we have our center pin, and we can hide our box again and we pre-compose, show the two compositions side by side, link the anchor point to our center pin, and our design is centered. Now if instead you want to say I want this entire thing to be left aligned, no problem. We forget here our center pin again, and instead we create a new pin at the left edge. And now we reveal the position of it, pick whip our anchor point to this position, and now the left edge of our design is centered. Let's hide the box again. And now obviously we don't want the left edge to be in the center, so we just change the position of this and say we want this to be, let's say, just 100 pixels from the left edge of our comp. And now our design is nicely left aligned, and this left edge of the design will always stay away 100 pixels from the left edge of our composition. So you can really use this for very complex layouts, no matter how complex they are, and you can use it to center, to left align, to right align, whatever. It's a very, very powerful, flexible, and simple approach. Okay, I hope you liked this tutorial. I'm Matthias from mamoworld.com. See you next time.